Hey everyone, so today my husband and I are going to do another little Q&A style kind of interview. And this time we're going to focus on a specific topic instead of it kind of being just, you know, random questions about mental health and bipolar in general. So we're going to focus on self-esteem this time. So I'm going to let my husband take over.
Okay, so we have a list of predetermined questions we're going to ask you that we thought up. We'll go ahead and start with the first one here. So my first question is, how much self-esteem do you feel you have on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 obviously being really low and 10 being excessively high? Where do you feel you fit in on that scale?
On a general basis, like overall throughout my whole life, I would probably say like a 3.
Wow, that's pretty low. Okay, moving on, in my opinion, of course. How does your self-esteem affect you in public places?
I generally compare myself to a lot of people. Mainly other girls, especially ones that are close to my age. And I don't know, I like pick out the things about them that I think are, I don't know, better than me, I guess. And I also get uncomfortable in certain situations, like if I'm out at, say, like, a bar or, like, a social situation or something, if I feel like everyone's looking at me, it makes me feel very self-conscious. Like there's a reason why people are looking at me. Almost like I'm wearing a sign around me that says I'm bipolar or something.
So it'd be fair to say that when you're in public places, your self-esteem affects you almost constantly.
It's always on my mind, yeah, but most of the time I can not let it, like, go out of control and give me anxiety unless I'm having an already crappy day or something like that.
Okay, so another question about how your illness affects you, and that would be, how do you feel your self-esteem affects your parenting, if it does at all?
I think about, like, how, sometimes I don't take proper care of myself, and I know as Eleanor gets older, she's gonna, like, maybe pick up on those things, and I don't want her to, like, pick up on, I don't know, my bad habits of certain things, like, not taking care of myself, like, especially my eating habits. Like, that's not something I want her to have.
So even though you feel this way, you would say it's very important for your daughter not to feel the same way?
Yeah, definitely. I don't want her to have self-confidence issues.
Okay. Moving on. If people compliment you on your looks or your ability to achieve a task or something, do you feel like they're being honest with you?
Most of the time, honestly, no. I don't feel like they're being honest with me.
Okay. We came up with that question because, you know, if you rate yourself at a 3, then there's obviously a lot of underlying issues that's going to cause. So for your husband, when I tell you that you're beautiful, what are you thinking? Knowing that, of course, I'm not going to judge you for how you feel.
Usually I'm thinking of a way to just brush off the compliment so that I don't have to deal with it or acknowledge it, I guess. And then there's other times when I don't even believe it from you.
Basically, like, I'm lying to you.
We've been together for almost 8 years, so.
Okay. So how young were you when you first realized you may have problems with your self-esteem?
Probably around the time I was about 12, I think. Well, 12 or 13, I think. And it was still like during the time when I was having to go every other weekend to see my dad. And for some stupid reason, I wasn't allowed to bring like the clothes that I had at my mom's place with me to my dad's. So I would have like this dresser at my dad's house that would have clothes that his girlfriend would buy for me, pretty much. And I swear I hated every single one of the clothes that were in this dresser drawer. And that's, I think, where it started for me, because I started feeling uncomfortable in my own skin wearing clothes that weren't mine, and I knew she was deliberately trying to dress me younger than I was, and it made me angry, and I didn't understand why my dad was letting it happen.
So in that sense, you felt like you were forced to be something you weren't?
Exactly.
Okay. You think you could give me just a few brief examples of what type of things make your self-esteem feel lower? Like what can happen in your environment, or what can people say? Maybe not so much the obvious.
When I feel like people are like brushing me off, like say I'm just like having a conversation with someone, whether it's on Facebook or like in person, and I say something that I don't know, maybe meaningful to me, and I'm expecting more of a response from the other person, and then when they don't give it to me, it kind of is crushing to my self-esteem. Like,
it makes you feel like they don't care, so it lowers your self-esteem.
Yeah, it makes me feel like, okay, I'm not worthy enough to have a conversation with, so okay. It kind of just shuts me down. Another example of low self-esteem. If I, like, when I was in school, I would always, you know, you obviously get assignments and essays and stuff like that. In my mind, I'd always have, like, a set goal for myself. Like, okay, this assignment, I'm gonna get no less than 95, say. And I would always set ridiculously high goals for myself, too. Almost like
unachievable.
Unachievable goals, deliberately trying to self, you know, sabotage without realizing. And when I would get, say, 93% instead of the 95, that 2% was just like soul crushing to me. Like,
okay.
Like it would literally eat away at me for days. Like, what could I have done to just get that extra 2% to get to the goal that I wanted?
So it'd be fair to say that you're fighting self-esteem from, like, the environment, from other people, and from yourself.
Yeah, pretty much.
So just another couple of quick examples of, and this might be a harder question since your self-esteem is so low. Are there any things that happen to you that make your self-esteem feel higher?
Yeah, there's plenty of things that make me feel good. Like when I get dressed up for girls' nights or something like that, and I like see myself looking good, then it makes me feel good. When I'm like achieving things, like when I'm working and I'm like people, like supervisors or managers are noticing, you know, my hard work, that like really makes me feel good about myself and my capabilities. And in school, like, every time that I would win an award or, you know, be the top of my class for the semester or whatever, that was a huge self-esteem booster, too. I think I deliberately, like, worked hard and gave myself ridiculous goals because I knew I needed those boosters in self-esteem sometimes.
Okay. So you're aware you have a self-esteem problem. Okay. To what degree do you feel your mental illness affects your self-esteem?
It just kind of adds in irrational thoughts with it. So you have to not only like fight against the feelings of just feeling like worthless or you're not good enough, but then you add in irrational thoughts to it and you have feelings like it's not, you know, just you're not good enough anymore. It becomes you're not good enough because you didn't do this right, or you didn't talk to this person in a certain tone, or you've overthought things too much, or you procrastinated, or, you know, like you just have all these irrational thoughts that get added in with the emotions of self-esteem, and it just makes it a lot more difficult to deal with.
Okay. We have a question written here, but I'm going to change it a little bit. I mean, so with the exception of pretty much before you were 12, you've always had a self-esteem struggle since then. Before you were 12, like you said, you feel like that's when it just pretty much started or manifested.
No, that's when I realized it myself.
Realized it? So you would say that your struggle has been long before 12 even.
Yeah, like...
So do you recall a time ever when your self-esteem wasn't a struggle? Maybe when you were just really young? Do you even remember?
No, okay. I remember being bullied in kindergarten. I remember having my first suicide attempt in grade 5. So...
That's actually make an interesting video. I think people might be interested to hear about something like that at an age so young, but have to save that.
I've always just had feelings of not being good enough, and my mom was a single parent, so we moved around quite a bit, like probably every 2 to 3 years if we were lucky. So that means new schools, new people constantly, and it seemed like no matter where I ended up, it was the same problems with people, the same people picking on me for the same reasons or whatever. So I just, like, I guess started believing it myself at around 12 because I'd been hearing it for so long.
Okay. So does your self-esteem ever, like, rapidly increase or decrease for periods of time?
Yeah, like, there could be times, like, say, like, I'm really excited about going out somewhere, and we walk in the door, and maybe I see someone from my past who, like triggers my emotions or something. That would, like, set me off.
Okay. So, the next question is basically, how does your level of self-esteem affect your general happiness? And I guess you could make that, you know, a scale of 1 to 10.
It makes it a struggle, but I mean, I try not to let it, like, get to me on a daily basis. And lately I've been, like, really trying to just, like, be a little more girly, I guess, and... make myself feel better about myself, because when I feel better, or when I'm, like, looking better, I can feel better, and vice versa. So I'm trying to work on it, but on a general scale, it comes in little spurts, I guess, throughout the day, depending on where I am and what I'm doing.
Gotcha. This should be a pretty straightforward question. At what point in your life did you feel the most self-esteem?
This one is kind of like, it's a combination of two for me.
Okay.
One is when I was elected democratically by my peers to be the president, like the new president of the Culture of Peace, which was our after school, like, humanitarian mission, and we basically did stuff in the community to raise money, and we would send some of the money back to a school in Afghanistan so women could go to school and have an education. And it was just something that was really close to my heart. So when I was elected president and everyone felt like I was capable of taking over the previous president's position, it was like a really big moment in my life. And the second one that's probably just as equal is when I actually graduated and I was the valedictorian of my whole year. It was just like a little bittersweet though, because the whole time I was in school, my mom was supporting me and taking me to school, and she was there for me. And then I think I graduated in June of 2011. And if you've been following my channel, you know my mom had her stroke in May. So my my mom couldn't be there for my graduation, but it was still one of the best moments of my life because I honestly worked my ass off for it, and it made me proud, even though my mom wasn't there to see it, that I still accomplished it.
Okay. Now I feel like when you answered that question, both of those were kind of like achievements. So let me ask you a spin-off question to that. When in your life have you felt the most beautiful? It can be a single day or a period, whatever.
On our wedding day?
I think I was just fishing for that answer. Bear with us, YouTube. Okay, so there's one last question, and I'll just touch on this before I ask the question. And my personal advice to you, Jackie, to help your self-esteem would be to believe people. When your husband tells you things, believe him. He doesn't have to say them. When your friends and family say things, believe them. Even if you believe that it's just because they're your family, you need to believe. And you especially need to believe in strangers and friends. So the last question is, what advice would you give to anybody to make them feel better about themselves if they're having self-esteem issues?
I would just say that, you know, you need to do things that make you feel good. So, you know, if you're into like doing your hair or your makeup, then do that. You know, if that makes you feel good, if that makes you feel confident, then do that. If, you know, like dressing up pretty and, you know, going to the grocery store and, yeah, like just getting attention is what makes you feel good, then do that. Like, I don't know what to say. Like, you have to find ways to make yourself feel good. And I'm finding it hard to find ways to make myself feel good, but I'm learning. For me, I like to sing a lot. It makes me feel good no matter what mood I'm in. When I start, when I end, I'm always in a better mood. So for me, that's my personal like outlet, my go-to thing for when I'm like really feeling down on myself. So I would suggest finding something like that, where there's something where that you can go to, you know, something you can outlet your feelings into, whether it's journaling, singing, you know, going for a walk, maybe it's photography, maybe it's picking up a new hobby and just trying something new. Just, you gotta find something that makes you happy.
Cool. Well, Jackie, thank you for the wonderful interview, and I'll let you outro the video.
Well, to my usual followers, thank you for your continued support. I'm working on some ideas for the springtime when I can actually be a little more mobile. I'm thinking about maybe doing some interview styles with some random strangers to maybe find out what people in my community know about mental health and maybe work from there. And just remember to stay strong and believe in yourself and know you're never alone.